long, long, long time ago, about 2,300 years ago to be a little more precise, there lived a man in ancient Greece called Euclid. Now, he looked nothing like this drawing, really. This is just my idea of how he looked. Over 1,000 years after he died, someone else thought he might have looked like this, but I prefer the way that I draw him. He looks more like an ancient Greek. Euclid wrote the first great book on mathematics and geometry. It must have been a really good book because they were still using it every day in schools well into the 20th century. Now, all the best ideas are simple and brilliant, and Euclid had a really simple and brilliant idea. He thought he would explain stuff from the very beginning by finding something very simple that everyone could agree with, and then he would build on that simple idea. He decided that a simple point, a fixed position in space, was a good place to start. You can think of a point as if it were an X on a map that shows where the treasure has been buried. Euclid explained this to his friends, and they said, "What a simple and brilliant idea. We get the point." "Now," said Euclid, "let's make another point and join the two points together." "Okay," everyone said, "we're happy with that." "Well, when we connect the two points together," Euclid explained, "we'll call the shortest distance between the two points a line. A line is a thing that has length but no breadth. At each end of the line, there is a point." "Yes," everyone agreed, "we understand." "Now, I'm going to call this an axiom," said Euclid. "An axiom is something everyone can agree with, a starting point from which we can begin to work out other stuff." "That is so cool," said his ancient Greek friends. Or something like that. "Have you got any more great ideas like that?" "Lots," said Euclid, "but that's enough for today. But tomorrow, I'll show you what happens if we have three points instead of two." "Cool," said his friends. Then they all drew diagrams in the sand. Some drew wiggly lines, some drew zigzags, some wrote their names. But whatever they did, they had to agree that the shortest distance between two points was made by a straight and simple line. Click here to see what happens to Euclid next, or have a look at the whole Geometry is Fun playlist. Whatever you do, make sure you're subscribed so you know when the next video is coming out. I'll look forward to seeing you then. Take care. Bye-bye.